As of May 28, 2023, there are currently 42 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the highly unusual Oldeyingolengai volcano in Tanzania, which is the only volcano in recorded history to erupt a type of carbonatite lava known as natural carbonatite. This lava, which is currently largely confined to the summit crater of Oldeyingolengai, is rare earth element enriched and erupts as a dark black color, which then cools as a type of white rock. It has an abnormally low viscosity and thus moves much like water. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In the United States, the number of actively erupting volcanoes increased from 1 to 2 as a shallow submarine volcano in the Northern Mariana Islands began to erupt once again. Meanwhile, at the Bulusan volcano in the Philippines, a special alert was issued due to a swarm of earthquakes which occurred, being the second such instance in the month of May. And, in what is this week's top story, the Popocatepetl volcano 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City is continuing to erupt at a heightened intensity. This towering stratovolcano typically produces volcanic explosions which occur at a rate of 1 to 28 explosions a week during its eruptive sequences, which have been mostly continuous since this volcano reactivated in 1994. However, about once every 5 years, the intensity of its primarily volcanic explosive eruptions temporarily increases, causing a layer of ash to fall over an area of hundreds to thousands of square kilometers. This is what happened during the last few weeks, where on May 12th of 2023, the number of daily minutes of volcanic tremor at the volcano caused by the movement of magma and/or volcanic gases began to progressively increase. This correlated with an increasing number of daily volcanic explosions and their associated intensity. A violent Strombolian eruption followed on May 20th, which distributed a layer of black ash, which destroyed a basaltic lava dome, being potentially caused by a temporary influx of a batch of basaltic magma. The following day, intense and acidic ash emissions occurred via numerous volcanic explosions, causing 4 millimeters thick of gray ash to fall as far away as 45 kilometers from its summit. Because of all of this, there is some good and bad news at Popocatepetl. The good news is that a recent overflight of its summit crater did not show any lava domes, meaning an imminent major eruption was quite unlikely. However, the bad news is that instead the crater was somewhat filled via a thick layer of ash and other volcanic debris, which could act just as well as a potential volcanic plug. Thus, in the next few weeks, there is still a possibility that a larger explosion might occur, which ejects the ash and debris in the crater, perhaps even generating a pyroclastic flow similar in length to the 8-kilometer-long pyroclastic flow produced during the December 2000 eruptive sequence. Meanwhile, in the Northern Mariana Islands, a new eruption occurred at a volcano in between the unpopulated Farallon de Paros and Mog Islands caldera volcanoes. There, at a depth of 137 meters or 449 feet below sea level, is the summit of the Ahyi Seamount volcano, which, on May 21st, produced its first eruptive signal in approximately 50 days, beginning at 10:10 p.m. local time. The following day, a discolored plume of water, likely created by the mostly effusive eruption of lava, was generated, being visible from satellite. This could mark a continuation of its nearly six-month-long eruption, which began in November of 2022, or it could represent a new eruptive sequence. In the Philippines, the Bulusan volcano had been at the lowest alert level of zero since January 18th of 2023, as this followed low earthquake activity and ground subsidence. Although the alert level of zero still remains as of May 26th of 2023, activity at the volcano has seemingly increased. As, during the month of May, it was confirmed that short-term inflation of its edifice is now ongoing, still having a 4-kilometer exclusion zone around its summit. Adding to this, between May 7th and May 9th, and on May 23rd, 17 and 37 volcanic earthquakes respectively occurred at depths of less than 6 kilometers. This was attributed to the movement of gas, which could indicate that the pressure potentially exists for another phreatic eruption to eventually occur, in my opinion. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 27th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.